Greetings, Chris Courtney here from New Pragmatic. Thank you so much for taking a moment out of your busy day to join me for this short discussion on using surveys and how to set up surveys using conditional logic. Let's start by pointing out the obvious. Surveys are a terrible tool for user research because we can't get close enough to the end user. Methods like observational research, user interviews, and product testing all are prime examples of research methods that allow us to actually observe the user and talk to them and interact with them. Surveys, on the other hand, are the opposite of that experience. They generate data, and we really have no ability to gauge the quality of that data. And we have no idea if the participants really contextually understood the questions they were being asked. As Erica Hall has said in the past, bad surveys simply don't smell. So if this is true, why do we use surveys at all? Well, surveys actually are an excellent tool when it comes to user recruitment. Yes, the survey itself is a terrible way to generate data. However, used correctly, it's a great way to generate a research cohort. Research cohorts are helpful to have because they allow us to build a base of people that we can reach out to for user interviews and also for testing a wide variety of products and processes that are related to the project that we're working on. So think about surveys as a way to find people instead of as a way to generate data. If you can do that, you'll avoid all the headaches typically associated with surveys and the faulty data they tend to produce. The next question is, how do we build our surveys? There's a few rules I'm going to roll out here. The first rule is really straightforward. Ask questions early on that will help you validate whether a person is somebody you want in your research cohort or not. The question on screen in this survey is an excellent example of an early question that can help identify whether somebody should be in or out of your cohort. For this survey on running, I'm simply asking, do you consider yourself to be a runner? That is asking a person about what they do, not who they are as a person. If you answer yes, I'm going to serve up questions to you that are related to running. If you answer no, I might take you down a different path. But I've already identified pretty quickly who should be in my research cohort and who's likely not in it. So remember, surveys that begin with demographic questions are surveys that we really want to avoid writing. Knowing the gender or economic status of your participants won't likely assist you if what you really need to know is whether they're runners or whether they have a peanut allergy or whether they own a dog or cat. As your first question should help you separate the field, you'll want to use conditional logic to create custom pathways for your survey to guide participants. Which brings us to the second rule. Don't ever present questions to participants that you know they can't answer. So an example of asking questions to people that they can't really answer is if I took the path of asking someone who had answered no to this question about whether they consider themselves to be a runner, if I asked them a question about what their favorite race distance is, that would be a clear question that they wouldn't really have a way to answer because they've already told me that they're not a runner. And that's completely fine. But we don't want to ask questions of people that they can't answer. That's going to lead to people bouncing out of your surveys. So this is where conditional logic or logic jumps come into play. This concept shifts the questions that you ask based specifically on the answers that are given. Understand that only certain types of data entry can be utilized for conditional logic. So if we go in here, you'll see that this is set to multiple choice. Currently, if the participant says yes, I'm going to continue on to the next section. But if they say no, I'm going to send them to a different section in this survey. Now, if this was not multiple choice and it was checkboxes, I no longer get the control to send somebody to a particular path. So in this particular case, using Google Forms, conditional logic is only possible if I am utilizing that multiple choice option. But even then, it doesn't just automatically come back. I have to come down here to the dropdown and go to section based on answer. And then I have to determine what section I want the user sent to. So in this case, they've answered no. I want them to go, instead of to the races, I want to ask them questions about runner support. Furthermore, once we get down to runner support, you'll see that this is multiple choice as well, but in each case, I really want them to go to the same section, the next section, which is planning for the future. So in that case, there are instances where your form will weave, and sometimes the questions that you ask will diverge, and sometimes they will converge in the same spot. Your goal with conditional logic is to remove questions that can't logically be answered by a particular user because they've already answered in a manner that negates those questions. The fewer unanswerable questions that you ask, the more likely it is that the user will finish the survey that they're taking, and the more likely it is that you'll end up with a larger potential research cohort than a smaller one. Which brings me to my final rule for surveys. Every survey you create needs to end with a request to contact. As we've covered here, the whole purpose of a survey is to generate a research cohort, a group of people that you can leverage for testing and interviews. Without asking for permission to follow up and contact later, I'm missing out on a huge opportunity, and this could potentially make my next research steps extremely difficult and potentially expensive. And again, I'm going to use conditional logic. People who say no, I'm simply going to take them down to the section that says thank you. But people who say yes, I'm going to take them to a section for email collection. Thanks for agreeing to participate. Please insert your email address below. And just like that, they've opted in to participating. If you found this video helpful, please mash that subscribe button. And if you're looking to grow as a designer, consider signing up for mentorship with me at newpragmatic.com. I'm Chris Courtney for New Pragmatic. Thanks for watching.